I said Revolution Live. Are y'all ready to get uncensored?
All right.
Boop. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of 99 Jamz Uncensored. All the way from Far Rockaway, New York City, Fat Joe.
Yo.
First correction, South Bronx, New York. Let's get that straight. What's up, y'all? Crack. What's good?
Welcome.
Got me fucked up now.
Ready to turn up?
I think I'm gonna have a mic in my ass, man. What's up?
Fat Joe's in the crib, y'all. Make some noise for Fat Joe.
Crack. Shout out Miami and this motherfucker.
So when we start, let's start real quick. Me and Nasty was talking earlier today, and this is something real interesting. Nasty was looking back. Nasty said,
Damn.
His first record dropped in 1993. That's over 20 years in the game. Over 20 years. And I think 11 solo albums. That's a blessing, brother.
Yep.
Hard work. Grinding. The Boricua's in here. Go ahead and give him a wepa, bro.
Well, you know, hip-hop is black and Latino since day one.
Absolutely.
So, me growing up in the Bronx, which I call a Mecca, the birthplace of hip-hop, I was exposed to Melly Mel, Grandmaster Flash, hip hop growing up, and that's how I fell in love with hip hop. And so, you know, as far as me, being Latino, being black in the Bronx, it never was a difference. We was always the same. So I never looked at it no different. What I could tell my Latinos is, I've been representing y'all for years. I've been trying to show y'all niggas how to get money, how to be fly, how to never sell your soul, how to be real niggas and never rat, be loyal. That's what I've been showing you through this whole 20 years. I hope y'all picked up on it.
Big time. Yo, tell me about the Digging in the Crates crew, bro.
Oh, well, that's the first crew I came out with. Lloyd Finesse, Showbiz AG, Diamond D, Big L. OC, Buck Wild, and you know, at the time coming up, it was the biggest rap crew in the game, and it was about real beats, real hip hop, real music, and then but I always was an entrepreneur since I was 14 years old. I always knew I wanted to be a boss, so I discovered people like Big Pun, Remy Ma, DJ Khaled, so forth and so forth. So I wanted my own thing, but I'm still digging in the crates. We actually got an underground Digging in the Crates album coming out this summer. So.
Wow. So being in that crew, that wasn't a time where you discovered Pun, though, was it?
Nah, I was first in Digging in the Crates. And then by my second album, I came outside of Bodega in the Bronx. And some niggas was rapping. And all of a sudden, you hear a nigga go, yo, chill, twin. Chill, twin, let me go. So then I stopped because I'm like, what is the fatter Puerto Rican gonna talk about, right? And the nigga was rapping. Nigga been trying to show me for 30 years, nigga. So the nigga was rapping, and the nigga was like, he was like, let me go. And he was like, da-da-da-da, batter you all, smatter you all, that, the big pun we know. So I'm looking at him, and then he just stopped and said, snatch the moon out the sky and blow the sun away. Me and my niggas playing hardball strictly. I was like, oh my God. And you know, believe it or not, I knew Puff Daddy when he was broke. I was there when he found Biggie. So as soon as I seen Pun, I was like, oh shit, this is my Puerto Rican Biggie. We gonna get some motherfucking money.
Thinking about Big Pun, if he was still here with us right now, like, and making records and stuff, What do you think? What do you see Pun being right now if he was still with us on Earth?
I mean, Big Pun was a genius, man. He would fall asleep, and he would wake up, and when he wake up, he'll grab a book and write a whole song. So he would dream about a song. He would dream and write all the lyrics down to the song. So, you know, he was way, you know, he was beyond a genius, man. He was light years ahead of niggas, man. And it's scary to know what kind of music he would have made, because he would have kept being the hottest nigga. There's no way around it. Same with Biggie. I believe Biggie would have still been hot now.
Is there anybody today that you would say, well, that reminds you of Pun?
No way.
Nobody in the game.
Nobody in the game reminds me of Pun. And you got to understand, Pun, Eminem, Jay-Z, Nas, these are artists that when you first heard their music, you was like, yo, these niggas are freaks of nature. It's been a long time since a rapper came in the game, and I'm not taking nothing from the young niggas, because I love all the young niggas, but it's been a while since you caught that freak of nature. They was like freaks of nature, bro.
What do you think? I mean, you're OG in the game, and you earned that status a while ago. What do you think is the state of hip-hop right now since you're speaking on the next generation?
I love it. You know, music got to elevate. Music got to evolve. You know, music takes its turns. You know, when we first came out, maybe Heavy D was like, yo, what this fat nigga doing rapping and shit? You know, and the older generation, they always look down at the younger niggas like, they shit is whack, we better. But that's not true, man. We got to give the young niggas their chance. You know what I'm saying? We've been doing music for so long. We need young niggas to come up to keep the game and the culture going. So we got to embrace the younger brothers. So I love what's going on in hip-hop.
What do you think was going on in New York hip-hop right now, though?
I think New York hip-hop is dope. All right. All the way up, huh?
Oh, trust me. We going to go there. We going to go there. Trust me.
Let me tell you something. People sleep on New York. But Nicki Minaj is from New York.
Talk about it.
French Montana's from New York. The whole ASAP crew is from New York. Fetty Wap Jersey will take them in New York. You got the whole list of cronies, 50 Cent, Jay-Z, everybody. Like, New York ain't fall off, my nigga. Like, everybody think of it. We even got the young nigga, the Panda.
Designer.
He's New York designer. He's New York / Atlanta. We'll take him. He's number one in the country. We'll take him. So this whole concept of New York fell off is really an illusion.
You said cronies. You know, 50 Jay. But you said Jay. Like, what? How did he become a crony?
No, I don't mean a crony. I mean the list of the usuals.
Oh, okay.
50
okay.
Cent's a big boy. Nas is a big boy. Jadakiss is a big boy. We can name all them niggas, but you should know about them. You know what I'm saying? So them niggas, I don't mean cronies. I just mean like the usual suspects.
Oh, okay.
Them niggas been killing forever, my nigga.
Right.
The usual suspects that's running hip hop. But let's go back and talk about let's talk about Pun real quick and Remy Ma. So I remember seeing where you founded Pun and Pun found Remy Ma. Tell me about the first time you met Remy Ma, though.
I was sick because Pun was like, yo, twin, come meet my artist. And Remy, she was so fucking hungry. And she was rapping her ass off. And she was like, I'm speakers, and I'm in the speeches. And I shoot the air bubbles out your sneakers. I'm trouble. You know what I mean? And I was like, oh my God. And I was actually jealous. I had anxiety because I was like, oh my God, I wish she was my artist. I had Big Pun. And I wish I had Remy Ma. And then once she finished rapping, I'm like looking at her. And then Punk come up to me, he said, "Don't worry, Twin, she's your artist. Don't worry about it. We gonna do her through you." I was like, "I love the girl. I fucking love her."
Are there like any artists that you said, you know, like you said with Remy, like you said, "I wish she was my artist." Are there any artists that are out there that you wish that you like, "Damn, I messed up. I should have got him.
I wish I had signed Pitbull when he asked me. I wish I had signed Rick Ross when he asked me."
Wow. Wow.
Damn, that's news.
"I wish I had signed Kent Jones when he asked me."
Whoa. Whoa. Shout out to Kent Jones, Broward County Zone. He in the building.
Wow.
Yep.
I wanna, is there anybody? Oh.
"Hey, yo, I wish I had signed Bryson Tiller when he was on the couch for 3 years.
Wow.
Talk about it. Is there a record that somebody reached out to you and said, "Yo, Joe, I need you to get on this," and you didn't get on it? Is there one that you regret that you didn't get on?
Well, the only one, "What you doing here, brother?" The only one I didn't really appreciate, I didn't want to get on. It was like a Tupac, after he died, they was making them albums where Tupac compilation, and they was putting them with niggas he didn't even like and shit like that. So I had turned that down, you know, but I had an opportunity to get on there. That's the only one that rubbed me the wrong way, you know?
Wow. So back to the Remy Ma situation. It's beautiful. First of all, it's beautiful to see y'all back together. It's a beautiful thing. Y'all make some noise for that, man. Like, how did it come to a point where y'all, like, fell out?
Well, I just think Remy was young and she ain't understand the business. So when she put out her first album, she was really upset because she put in all this work and she expected to do a lot better than what the first album did. But you know, a lot of artists, some guys are luckier than others. You know, just the other day, Jay-Z said, "Yo, Joe, God loves you." And I looked at him and I said, "Man, he loves you a little bit more, my nigga." And that's just the case. Some artists come out. Look at Kent Jones' first song is number 7. His shit gonna go number 1 in America. And that's not easy. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, some guys, you know, they got faster success than others. So we fell out because of that. And then she went to jail. And she realized after all those years, the nigga who really helped her, helped to get money, always watched her back, always made sure people respect her, wanted the best for her, was Fat Joe. So when she came home, we connected. And the rest is history. Y'all see what the fuck is going on out there.
Big time.
All the way up.
And I know when she went in, like a lot of her circle changed when she got out. I mean, you spent some time in there too. Talk to me about that.
FDC Miami, nigga.
Yeah.
What's up? Anybody who works in FDC, what's going on, my niggas?
They watching you right now in the 99 Jam.
Yeah, they
too.
Snuck in.
Tell me about that stint. Like, I know when you went in and then you got out, your circle changed probably. Your mindset changed.
Well, let's be clear. When I went to jail, I went to jail for something I didn't do. That's just the truth. I had an accountant who I hired to do my taxes, and the nigga fucked me. And I showed the government that he fucked me because I showed him the proof that I was giving him the money, and they still said, "You as the leader of your household, you are responsible." So they made an example out of me. So that's why I got locked up, and I paid them back their money on top of that. So now I'm in jail. They got me with all type of killers and kingpins and murderers and fucking FDC. I don't know if you know FDC Miami. It's where the biggest drug dealer in Colombia is at. The biggest killer in Jamaica is at. Wow. The biggest kid. You know, it's the hub for the criminal Caribbean niggas. The Puerto Rican nigga who shot the warden 600 times. He was sitting next to me.
Oh, wow.
And I'm doing 3 months in jail. Like, what the fuck is this nigga doing next to me, B? Fucking amazing. So I'm going to tell y'all some shit happened in there. Somebody give me a napkin, a tissue, something. One time we up in there, and some nigga says, I said, "Yo, what you in here for?" Nigga said, "Yo, I robbed the bank, crack."
One of them
I got 18 years. I was like, oh, word, damn. I said, my man, what you in here for? He said, yo, I got caught with 20 keys of coke. I was like, oh, shit. He's like, yo, I got 14 years. Oh, sorry to hear that. Yo, my man, what you in here for? Yo, kingpin, couple of armed robbery. Oh, yeah. Well, guess what? I'm innocent, everybody. I'm fucking innocent. Niggas was looking at me like, shut the fuck up, crack.
So I'm saying, like, what advice would you give, like, to an artist when it comes to financial responsibility and taxes and all? What type of advice would you give?
You got to be able to understand it yourself. Get accountants to watch accountants. Get lawyers to watch lawyers. This shit crazy, man, because money will make your brother turn on you. So you got to really be on top of your finances. And like Oprah Winfrey says, they ain't a check she don't sign herself.
Now let's talk about this, because I saw our dog Khaled. Shout out to Khaled right now. We're on the Beyonce Formation tour.
Believe that.
It's amazing to see how much a few years can do for somebody. Like Jay, he said, God loves you. And you say God loves you more. God loves Khaled. Yeah,
for real.
You were the first one who give Khaled a chain.
I was the first nigga to put Khaled on.
How did that happen? How did that whole situation happen?
Let's be clear. There's a couple of DJs in here tonight. Khaled was DJing in the back room, and Super Cindy know that shit. Skinny nigga like this. I fell in love with the nigga and put him on. So just be clear. So he took the baton. So I go like this. So Khaled kept bothering me. Right? So Khaled was like, yo, I could be a star. I could do an album. I could be a star. Meanwhile, Lean Back, number one in the country. I'm like, all right, my nigga. He's like, no, I'm telling you, I could be a star. I could be a star. This, that. And I'm like, so I go up to New York and I tell a nigga, yo, Khaled is Fat Joe on steroids. He's the man. The record label nigga's telling me, I don't know this nigga. Like, yo, Joe, I don't want to fuck with this nigga. I never heard of him. And I'm like, yo, I'm telling you, he gonna be the biggest nigga in the world. I did everything but got on my knees for this nigga, man. Wow. And next thing you know, they signed him, and the nigga been making hit records ever since. So you gotta give him credit for coming from this cloth, but able to make his own lane. And we proud of him, because right now, DJ Khaled like the fucking Beatles right now, my nigga.
Big time.
Yeah.
You remember back then, 2004? Lean Back?
Oh, y'all remember Lean Back?
I remember that.
You do it! Throw your hands in the air right now,
you
man.
Do it!
Feel this shit right here! Stay off, nigga! Yeah! I see you, nigga! Shut this boy, man! Yeah! Give a fuck about your faults or mishaps, nigga. We from the Bronx, New York. Shit happens. Kids black, love is spark the place. And the niggas in the squad got a scar on their face. Now it's a cold world and this is ice. A meal for the charm, nigga. This is life. The phantom in front of the building.
The Trinity, yeah.
10 years, militant, they still
figure me bad.
I'm as a youngin', it's too much to cope.
Why you think?
Motherfuckers nicknamed the coke shit. Should've been called on rock. So, I'm in the grandma's. I did it all, I put the pieces to the puzzle. Just gone, I knew me and my people was gone.
Bubble,
came out the game, on some flow drop shit. That nigga with the shiny was a low coke kid. I said, my niggas don't dance, we just
Hey!
Come on, I said, my niggas don't dance, we just some motherfucker lean.
Oh. Man, that gave me memories.
Anthems.
I was a sophomore in high school when Al came out. He had cats down here in Miami doing Lean Back like it was from Bronx, New York, too. You had the whole world doing that.
The whole world doing that.
Speaking of, let's talk about this, too, Joe. You were the king of anthems before Khaled was the king of anthems. I got another one of my favorites, Get It Poppin'. You remember that one?
You remember Get It Poppin'?
Revolution Live, y'all remember Get It Poppin'?
Whoa.
Yes, go.
Come on.
Number one.
Oh,
company.
Five.
Yeah. Come on.
It's too hot in the morning, girl. And the DJ playing that song.
Nigga, what you gonna do? Not my favorite song.
You say that's not your favorite song? What is one
what
of
is
favorite
your favorite song?
Song?
New York.
The one with Ja Rule.
Wow.
Wow.
Another one.
Wow.
Wow.
This is.
I got a honey guns.
I got a honey guns on the chips. We all from. I gotta send me on a manifest this next time if
you talk, you talk.
I got 100 ways to make it quick. Yes, I'm from
New York, I'm New York.
And you can tell I'm getting ignorant.
Nigga, I'm from New York, I'm New York. This is how we do.
Nigga, I can see the coke in your nose. This ain't a movie, but he got his head blown on the globe. And I was just about to find God. But now that Mace is back, I think I'm much rather find a Bernard. And everybody talking crazy how they AK sit. But we done disinvestigate. And they ain't spray shit. Not me, I'm a truth homie. Got the industry shook like nah, nigga, chill. Don't let them loose on me. True story, I'm bringing the team back. Even Roy Jones is forced to lean back. My nigga Drake.
Boy. And another one. So let's talk about Khaled. So I heard this too. I heard Khaled's game, his sneaker game.
Uh-oh.
It's semi-close to Fat Joe's.
Never.
Think so?
Never.
So, do you have, like, Khaled has this whole, he's got like a whole house of sneakers.
He has a beautiful collection. But Fat Joe will pull out shit that never been worn before. Never been seen before. One of one. That's why when everybody talk about sneaker battles, nobody want to battle Fat Joe. Because I'll pull some shit out. They all know. It ain't Khaled's fault. It ain't no sneaker collector's fault. I just got that shit. I've been collecting for 15, 20 years.
You have like a favorite shoe, like a favorite sneaker? Like one sneaker was like...
My favorite sneaker I posted on Instagram. It was when Kobe retired. I've had it for like 15 years. It's the Sixers. The Jordan and Kobe are two different entities. They never made a shoe together. I had the only shoe ever made combination with both of them. And because I bought it from the nigga who designed it, he got fired from Nike.
Wow. Wow.
Let's be clear.
Well, damn. It's a lot of sneakerheads in the game, but I never heard that story, though.
Can't fuck with me, man. Nobody.
Wow.
So, look.
Keeping it 100.
I never knew that story. And a guy got fired because you're getting...
How y'all feeling out there?
Oh, man.
Oh, Jill, you're snitching mics.
Yo.
Okay, cool. Cool. What's those? What's those?
I see you, my brother. I love them shit.
What's those? So, anyway, let's talk about how you make your music, too. Because you got these anthems, right? I heard a funny story that... You actually, like, you go out in the clubs and stuff. Nasty told me about a birthday bash party that he did, and you popped up in there. You was like, yo, I like to be in here because this the hood. This is where I'm from. I like the hood. Like, you don't like that Hollywood stuff, right?
Yeah,
you like to go to a club where somebody's standing on the couches and dudes throwing their money up in the air, making it rain and stuff, right?
Are you saying you want to hear Make It Rain?
I mean, I got a special request.
I'm in it.
We hear the echo.
Man, I see the presto. Good seeing how that metal. I'm a hustler, hustler. A pusher, pusher. You a buster, customer. I get just a cooker. Your craft is a chemist. I'm back in 11. I'm back in the 7.
I clap at your resume.
I see you in there, why? I see you in there, why? You gon' need your work. That's the cup that we live by.
Yeah, I'm in this venue with terror.
Let me tell you a story about Make It Rain.
Please,
please.
New York City wanted to kill me when I made that record. Cause Fat Joe being from real hip hop, digging in the crates, Don Cartagena. They were so mad I made a record that was bouncing like this. So I said, why is everybody so mad at the South for? Change the style up, switch to Southpaw. So what happened was, I was in Memphis, Tennessee, and I had a show, and I went to a club. And it was a DJ trap house. And all night, all the nigga kept playing was trap music, trap music, trap music, trap music. And so I'm looking, and the way you gotta, how many people are trying to be rappers or are rappers? Right? Okay. So I'm gonna tell you a secret. I go, Fat Joe goes, and I sit in the club. And you might think I'm being arrogant or I'm being a dickhead, but I'm just studying the crowd and I'm seeing what they like, what the girls love, how they moving. So all night that night I was studying the crowd and I noticed they didn't play one East Coast record, no New York. And at like 4 a.m. the nigga said, yo, let me take you to back in the days. And he threw on like, they call me Hov, hey, sit up. And it was actually hot at the time. That's when I knew music was changing. So I flew to Miami and I went to Scott Storch and I said, yo, Scott Storch, I want to make a song like this. The nigga argued with me and I was like, trust me, we got to make one. And that's when I came up with Make It Rain. And you know, Make It Rain, the word Make It Rain is a household name. You know, you got to really think about this, right? This Q&A is so that you can really understand something. That's kind of crazy Fat Joe made that shit up. That's really crazy. Know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's incredible to be able to give back to the hip hop community to where it's a term every nigga use all day, every day. I be watching commercials in the bank and it be a white nigga throwing money like this, talking about, yeah, I'm making it rain on interest. Shit crazy.
With interest.
With interest. So listen. So let's go back a little bit. So I want to talk about like some comparisons, like different types of Fat Joes, right? Musically, I want to know the difference from Fat Joe, I Won't Tell, to Fat Joe, Another Round.
Well, I'll let y'all tell me, come on.
Kills Mania.
This went number 3 in America. Hey. Independent. I'll tell you about that.
Fresh off the runway, Pierre Rodgers. Been on top drop on that I-95. PC is like a suit, who would I? On my way to party, I could root and rock. Now I ain't gotta tell you that the boys pop bottles. And mommy's looking like America's top model. She said to earring, look at that thing. That's even bigger than the rock on my ring. Now she got a man, place for the whole time. Like, come on, you know me, run New York. Chains in the background, put you to bed. Says he got brains, so I'm looking ahead. And I'm looking for bread, I gotta eat on these streets. 17-5, got the holler at G's. I'm a real G, real G's do real things. And I can keep a secret, it's the song that I sing. Yeah, I won't tell.
If you don't
want me to, I do anything for you.
Girl,
anything for you.
As any point, at At any point through the night so far, have you said to yourself, my God, this nigga got so many hits, I forgot? At any point has it, have you figured it out yet?
Don't you be holding back, your love, don't you be holding back.
Have you figured it out?
Don't you be holding back, your
yeah,
love,
I
don't
niggas.
You be holding
I
back.
I wanted them niggas!
It's in the end,
come on!
Another round,
hey.
Another round.
You got that one up!
Another round,
you got that one up!
I used to want you in heaven, 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 you in heaven.
I used to want
you in heaven, heaven, heaven. I want, I want, I want.
Shorty got a
meanwhile,
a bitch,
your
bitch better than any bitch that
you made.
I'm talking,
you
made me. I heard Rihanna.
She got the king.
Quit playing, girl, you know that you want it. I can tell just by the way you push it out and pull it. You
bad,
stuckin' like a Anita. Body dope and sterile, the sex is hard to
handle.
Your ass couldn't
beat it,
I hit it like a
sweet dough.
It's just I lost some weight, you say I
got a big ego.
It's too strong, this is your dropstick. Well, baby, just
peel off.
Mama, now it lasts long.
Leave the sheets, good sheet.
Fuck you with the
mask on, Halloween pussy.
Your body's tender, the trouble drip each and every stroke. Pussy wetter than
don't
ever,
you
but
you
still to
love. Love, don't you be holding back. Don't you be holding back. Your love, don't you be holding back.
Say what?
Just in the end, girl, you come on another round.
What up, man?
That was one of my favorites.
And just to warn it,
he's, one of mine too.
He's still got more hits too, by the way. Matter of fact, this the real Fat Joe fans, do y'all remember Flo Jo?
You think they're ready for that?
Yo.
Uh-oh.
Jola! Get that. Let me tell you, this record right here, a lot of y'all might be too young, but it came out 23 years ago and went number one in America.
Talk about it.
And it feels so great that 23 years later, we got the number five song in America. Let's go. Let's get it.
Yeah.
You want real hip hop?
Gangsta.
Gangsta.
So let's
you know what? I ain't snap yet, man.
You haven't? Oh yeah, you on Snapchat?
I gotta snap.
He on Snapchat. You just snap back there. His Snapchat popping too.
What's your Snapchat?
Fat Joe TS.
Y'all follow that. Fat Joe TS on
Don't
Snapchat.
Don't laugh at my phone. It's the only one I got for Snap. Say what's up. I see the bodies.
We got a group of boardies over here, boricuas, what up?
Smart guys. Smart guys.
Let's go back to 1993. So what's the difference between Flo Jo and the Fat Joe who made Slow Down with Jeezy in 2011?
Well, that's a good question. Because they both in like the same lane.
Yeah.
Are you trying to say you want to hear Slow Down? You getting a fucking concert.
Yo, I like this though.
I like where this is going.
They working me. Yo, chill, y'all working me.
Ha ha.
Yeah, yo.
It's a gang keys and Jay-Z to get the city rockin' now. Raw bass, new dog, get it rockin' now. Big money, talk me with the back now. Gucci soft up, cause you can't hide talkin' now. Know what your boys got a death wish. I be the motherfucker uglier than Preston. Real nigga, you can find me with the X's. Whippin' in the kitchen, both hands, I got a
hold up! Woo. Another hit. Another hit. So tell me about
that. Well, let me tell you about being independent. That song changed my life. Because niggas be wanting to sign to these record labels, but they be sitting in front of your face and they be lying to you, telling you they working your shit. They gonna blow you up. They gonna spend money on promoting you. Radio, that record was a hit. That record was a hit, but it didn't really chart right. But the niggas in the record label was telling me, yo, we putting the money behind it. I knew they lied to me. So from that point on, I went totally independent where I put my own money where my mouth is. And I got my crew, little 3-4 man crew. And we've been going number 3, number 2 in America ever since, doing it ourselves. Now you gotta understand, when you're independent, I'm going up against major labels who got 700 workers doing what 4 niggas is doing. That's how hard the shit is. And we still bust they ass all the time.
I know it was a point, like, it's a lot of cats out there that'll count you out because you'll make an anthem and then you'll disappear for a second and then you'll pop back up with another anthem and you'll disappear. And now my man's all the way on the charts right now. Y'all know about this record.
But you know where I be. I make an anthem and then I go pick up every bag in the world and then come back to make another one.
I mean, they've been counting you out, Joe, and then you come back with this record, this huge-ass record, which is probably going to be the anthem of the summer. I mean, you just dropped a remix.
Which is probably?
No,
it is. It is. What it's you
even
thought?
A remix. It's called I'm All The Way which Up. You remember that?
Now, hold up. Shout out to Kool & Dre.
But let's talk about that, though. Let's talk about that real quick, though. So you and Remy.
Yo, my nigga, is the biggest song in the country.
It is. Trust me, we know. I mean, we play it every night. Like, make movies on the 9 o'clock.
I know you are.
Yeah, big time. Did you hear just last night?
Shout out to homeboy Fly Havana. He worked on the record. My nigga Exclusive, Infrared, Kool & Dre. See, Kool & Dre, by the way, Kool & Dre are super producers from Miami. Fat Joe discovered them too. I don't know if you know. Those are my brothers. They were sleeping on my couch for a long time, too. Now them niggas is rich. They from North Miami. And now we got like a factory going on where we got Kent Jones, we got Illa, we got Exclusive. We got all upcoming producers making music, writers, rappers. Like, we in there every day making music together. And it's a beautiful vibe, man. And you all the way up?
All the way up back there in the corner.
Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
I saw my wife, she snuck in here. Give me a song for my wife, please.
Put the fucking mic on.
Mic is on. Joe practice on,
Say
hey! Say do this shit, do this shit, do it!
About
yeah. Got to do it, baby.
let you know from the gate I don't go down ready. I want a chick with the kicks and excellence. She can be the office type or like the script. Will you give me a rise? I look in my eye. Must you talk too much, man? You ruined in my eye. I don't wanna lose the feeling, cause the roof is still in this on fire. And you looking good, getting on my rider. Wondering over the open and the provider. Used to see the jury on my women and I living it up. Why's that filling the truck with chicks that's willing to piss with us? You say you got a man and you're in love, but what's love? You're in love, but what's love got to do with a little menage? Having a party, me and you, you just lie for you and she can come to what's love?
Got to do, got to do with it, baby.
So you back in the studio too, and you and Remy got an album coming out.
That's what I'm talking about, Joe.
And the title of the album, though, that's interesting. Plata o Plomo.
What does that mean?
Plata o Plomo. Who's seen Pablo? Who's seen Narcos? Well, I'm a big fan of Narcos, Pablo. And Pablo Escobar be having 18 wheelers worth of cocaine. Police stop him and be like, yo, what you got in the truck? And he be like, yo, I got cocaine. So he tells the cops, he says, listen, I could give you a whole lot of platas, meaning money, and we be good, take this money, or I could give you this plomo, this lead, these fucking bullets. More than likely, they take the money.
Talk about it.
Wow, money and bullets.
Let's talk about this album, because I just love the fact that you and Remy Ma's relationship can define a lot of people's relationship with their best friends, right? How your brother and sisters, right? You have a falling out, you make up, and now you're back in the studio. The thing is, I think the basis of the story is y'all just keep it 100 with each other at all times.
Yup.
And now y'all in the studio.
Well, listen, ladies, where the ladies at? Make some motherfucking... Now, let's be clear about this shit. Remy Ma won Female Rapper of the Year 7 years ago. 7 years ago. But she was gone for 7 years. Guess what? She gonna win Female Rapper of the Year right now. Oh, you don't believe me?
What you need, shorty, what you want, I got what you need.
I'm all the way up. 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 Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up. For my niggas in Bentley cruising Rolexes. Kick the bitch out the room and give her no breakfast. Had to stash the jewels, these bitches so reckless. I keep my hoes, my crews, I'm talking naughty uptown, showing off for new things. Couldn't take it all, so I gave her own change. She called me Tough Shutter, yeah.
Keep a few tings, champion sound, yeah. I got a few rings,
and I'm all the way up. And
you can stay up. And if you ask anybody where I live, then point to the hill to say, go all the way up. Go all the way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
Just left the big house to a. Ain't have a girlfriend, but the Chanel croc bag shit ain't with the gold chains, Himalayan Birkin. King hit it up, pop shit. I hit him up, I'm talking color money, purple yin and blue dirt.
Hold up!
The biggest record in the country.
Hold up! Don't say nothing else. I gotta do this. They've been asking for it.
Ready for war,
Joe? How you wanna?
Wanna blow these rocks?
I know some dirty cats.
Try to get us in the field with some rocks.
I've been the hummer of bullets. We need needles and drills and drills to
white. Spaghetti.
Everybody get
the fucking floor.
Joey Jack.
Fucking
war. Hit
them all. Shoot that fucking war.
Dead in the middle of little. Then we know that we riddle some middle. Then do the. The Boricuas, they was asking for
it. Yeah, you had to give it to them.
And I still can't do that part.
Hey, so listen. You were talking about the laboratory that you got going on, the laboratory with all the rappers and producers and artists and everything you got going on. So how did this whole
kid... I need a towel.
Another one.
Pretty Lou. You been to New York. You know the hottest thing in New York is Pretty Lou.
Shout to Pretty Lou. But talk to us about this Kent Jones. Talk to us about Kent Jones.
Well, man. Shout out to Illa the producer. Fucking phenomenal producer. Y'all gonna hear him soon. Y'all been hearing him. And then the whole Epidemic family. So Kent Jones, he's somebody I fell in love with. He's a beautiful person, beautiful soul, and he loves music. So I started working with him and helping develop him as a producer. And then I got in trouble with the police. At that point, I felt it wasn't fair for me to have him counting on me when my shit was fucked up. So I passed them on to Kool & Dre, and they kept working with him and working with him and working with him. And now he got the biggest song in America. Kent, where you at, Kent?
Where is he?
We can't tease
Kent,
him.
Kent, where you at?
There you go.
We can't tease him.
There you go.
Revolution Live, what's up? We got to give them what they want. We got to give them what they want. Yeah, hola. Hola, na. Whoa. Yeah, sing it. I know you know it. If you know it.
She be telling me this and telling me that. You say once you take me with you, I never go back. Now I got a lesson that I wanna teach. I'ma show you that where you from. Don't matter to me, She said, well, I come on, stop. She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, ma. Then she said, ça passe. And I said, no matter where I go, you know I love her, mama. She said, well, I come on, stop. She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French.
Hold up.
I said, bonjour, ma.
This shit number one in America.
We love the TV.
Oh my God, I can't fucking believe it. Yo, listen, this is my little brother. Every time I hear his record on the radio, I get so fucking happy. Nobody deserves it more than Kent Jones. Let's go.
I wanna see some lights. Let me see them phone lights. Where the lights at? Oh, your phone ain't got no flash? She keep telling me this, telling me that. You say once you take me with you, I never go. Now I got a lesson that I wanna teach. I'ma show you that where you from. Don't matter to me, to me. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, ma. Then she says, I'm passing. And I said, I'm bullet. No matter where I go, you know I love her mouth. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, madame. Then she says, I'm passing. And I said, I'm bullet. No matter where I go, you know I love her. Come on. For sure, told her baby come and ride the rodeo. Every time I come around, man, go for bro. She give me that top till I over. Now baby, you gon' go where you're supposed to go. Cause I ain't got time for you every day. She say she got a man keeping on the low. I said he don't speak English to telling me this and telling me that. You say won't you take me with you, I never go. Now I got a lesson that I wanna teach. I'ma show you that where you from. Don't matter to me. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichi. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, ma. Then she says, I'm out there. And I said, na boule. No matter where I go, you know I love her. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, ma. Then she says, I'm passé. And I said, na boule. No matter where I go, I think you know I love her, ma. She from Africa, but she black, but the mind freaking Asia. I gave her the candy Kansas. I got it on. She on candy camera. Okay, see, I forgot we met at Oakland. I used to smoke Regina, she from Arab. Then I met a girl in Cali, I never disown her. She got that high grade. A week home with diplomas. I want her, but she keep telling me this and telling me that. You say once you take me with you, I never go back. Now I got a lesson that I wanna teach. I'ma show you that where you from. Don't matter to me. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, madame. And she says, I'm passing. And I said, na boule. No matter where I go, you know I love her, mama. She said, hola, como esta? She said, konnichiwa. She said, pardon my French. I said, bonjour, madame. And she says, I'm passing. And I said, na boule. No matter where I go, you know I love her, mama. She said, hola, como esta?
He's a pillar in the
community. Said bonjour, madame. Then she say sabase. And I say na boule. No matter what I.
Hold on, Uncle Crack.
You keep telling me and telling me. You say once you take me with you, I never. Now I got up that I wanna. I'ma show you that where you from. Don't mind. Sing the rest of it. She said. Then she say.
Revolutionize, give it up for yourself. Give it up for my Uncle Joey Crack.
Hold up. Breaking news. He's not a one-hit wonder. Breaking news. He will be around 10 years from now. Breaking news. That nigga got 1,000 hits coming your way.
It's gone.
So get used to him. The hat might change. The color of the hat might change. But get used to this nigga.
Hey, let me ask you a question, Kent, if you don't mind, let me ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
You remember a record called Ceiling to the Sky?
You remember Ceiling to the Sky, Uncle Crack?
I don't remember it, but he produced it for me, but if you asking me to perform it, I don't remember the words, nigga.
No, we're going.
I'm sorry.
What was the first session like with y'all two in the studio?
Me and Kent did so much work together. He's actually, you know, what happens is, let me tell y'all something. Please pay attention, right? Please. What happens is, the song is a hit. Oye, como esta? Si se con ejiwa. Right? It's a hit. But niggas might get it fucked up and think he's the nice guy rapper. Like, Kent Jones spits his ass off. He's an ill rapper. He's probably the best young nigga in the game right now. So get used to the hits and get used to him spitting his ass off. The guy's a phenomenon. That's it. He's a phenomenon. Get used to him.
What was the first session like, though?
I don't know, nigga. What you want me to do? He was like, you know, all these niggas, they my brothers. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I see them, I give them advice, they give me advice. And we just a giant family, man. So I love all of them, from Pat to all of them. They all my family, B, Ella, and vice versa.
Uncle Craig.
I never try to act like I'm better than them. I never try to downplay nobody. I show love. If we got one piece of chicken, we all share one piece of chicken. If we got 100 pieces of chicken, we all share 100 pieces of chicken. We just a family.
What they don't know is Sentence to the Sky was actually the record. This is real important, y'all. This is real important. Sentence to the Sky was actually the record that I met Uncle Crack off of. That was the record that we actually met him off of. The very first time. We did so much work, it's like we had to kind of dig to remember the first session. But that was the record that he just.
Oh, he's on the album, Plata Plomo.
Oh, he is on the album.
Oh, no, he's in the album. He's one of the only niggas on that album.
Wow.
Nah, shout out Remy Ma, shout out Uncle Crack.
What day is that coming out, Plata Plomo?
I want to know.
Probably end of July, first week in August. I mean, we just dropped the remix yesterday with Jay-Z. So, how many people heard the remix with Jay-Z? I like Remy verse.
Remy got
the Yo, you got the remix. Play the remix. I'm not performing.
Cool and Dre.
Let's vibe.
This is.
Let's listen.
The remix for the city. Let's just start snapping. Crack hit bleak on the jack. Like, let's make it happen.
Oh, it's
nothing
me.
Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
Shorty, what you want? Shorty, what you need?
What you need?
My niggas run the game, we ain't never leave,
never leave.
Counting up this money, we ain't never sleep,
never sleep.
You got V12, I got 12 V's. Got bottles, got weed, got money.
I'm all the way up.
Shorty, what you want? I got what you need.
Need.
Shorty, what you want? I got what you need.
Huh?
Shorty, what you want? I got what you need.
I'm all the way up.
You know you made it when the fact you mash made it is worth millions. Lemonade is a popular drink and it still is. Survival of the littest. Niggas who really up verse, niggas up in your business. I'm in the room where real niggas not allowed. I'm the only one in the room that they fear right now. I think they clear right now. Let's celebrate, no red champagne, we don't play that. All we see is gold bottles and paper plane hats. 21 Grammys that I use for Douce cups. I'm on the penthouse floor, call you what ya? The OG said, hold, high is high enough. I said, till we eye and eye with the higher ups. Until we let them know we ain't those niggas. Until our baby showered in gold, nigga. Blue looking like Pac in the tub. David LaChapelle levels and not giving a fuck. Prince left his masters where they safe and sound. We never gonna let the elevator take
us down.
This wasn't me, this was God's doing. And this time I won't finger roll Pat Ewing. They ain't wanna see the squad in the rock. Now they chasing the Wraith like Mr. Softies on the block. Stars on the roof, got a feeling like Venus. Getting so much brain, now I'm a dog called a genius. Ever since one been gone, been independent. So I went in through the punch jump, man, I'm independent. I flooded out all the crisis. Out of Paris, I learned what real ice is. I'm kicking flavor in your ear. I just had a gray on my face and it disappeared. I just dropped the biggest of checks and the shit cleared. When everybody counted us out just this year. I'm Steph Curry in the clutch. Take a shot of this royal elite and go all the way up.
My swag, my flow, I stole it back. They mad, too bad, my shows is packed. My town, my crown, I really rap. I'm home, my throne, I spoil you that.
When the bitch was gone, they was really playing with it. I was sitting listening like they ain't even saying shit. Battle real is back, I see they all trying to change and shit. But it's really too late now, I'm of these bitches gotta die. Three of these bitches, four of these bitches gonna cry. Five of these bitches popping pills, they high. Six bird bitches, none of them get fly. See, I don't wanna hear about your records and big numbers, cause I was up top seven winners and six summers. Cuffed all on that bus, locked me all the way down. Now I'm all the way up.
I told you. By the way, that came out Tuesday because me and DJ Nasty were the first to play that the radio on 99 Jamz.
I don't want to hear about your records and big numbers.
Whoa.
Because I was locked down seven winners and six summers. Cuff. All on that bus. Locked me all the way down. Now I'm
all the way up.
Toughest verse on the remix. I'm sorry.
Young ladies.
Let's talk to Kent real quick, though. Let me talk to Kent real quick for a second.
Talk to Kent.
Kent.
Talk to me.
You got one of the hottest records in the country right now.
Right, on the charts. Yeah.
With Don't Mind.
I like that.
99 Jamz, we played that back way back in September of last year.
You started it.
Yeah. No doubt.
Jill believed in the record from day one.
Yes, she did.
Jill Strada.
Anyway, Kent, you just talk your shit.
Okay. How was it? For the first time to hear your record on 99 Jamz.
Nah, it was amazing. Especially knowing that the whole team was rocking with me. The whole team was on my side the whole time, and it was dope. It was just dope. And
so,
it was dope to hear it. It was dope to hear it and not know what was coming on. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, some people like, listen to the radio, my soul coming on. You're like, nah. It's just you riding, and then it comes on. It's like
huge.
So the record's so big now. We know.
Yes.
Well, we hope there's a remix coming.
Oh, there is. Who ready for that Don't Mind remix, man?
I'm ready for
it. That was cute. That was all right.
Joe on it.
I'm ready for it. So, can you say who on the remix?
Man, it's going to be some big people on the remix. It is big people on the remix right now. It's not finished.
So, there is a remix to it.
There's a remix, for sure.
Okay. When the remix drops.
Yes.
You stop by 99 Jamz at 9 o'clock on a weeknight.
Who says I'm not going to be there already when it drops?
Okay, I'm just inviting you. I'm just putting that out there. By the way. So, Joe, let's talk about you one more time, bro, because I wanted to talk about how every year you say you'll drop a record and you'll go collect them bags, and it looks like you have wiped away from the scene for a second, and you come back and you drop another hit on them, right? You got that I'm all the way up. Was there at any point where you were discouraged on making records with the music industry the way it is?
Well, what happens is, when I started to make this album, when Remy said, yo, bro, let's work on a new album, you gotta realize Lean Back was number one 47 weeks. It ain't but 52 weeks in a year. So I was like, yo, I don't wanna fuck up that combination. So maybe that's the first time in my career that I had so much pressure. So I was going everywhere. I don't know if you don't know, I don't get high. And I start getting high. I start going to the club getting drunk. I start dancing. I went to Toronto to see what them niggas was drinking. I went to the Jamaican clubs, ATL, Dominican clubs. Nigga, I was everywhere trying to catch that wave. Because it's hard to make some dope music coming from where I come from, and the nigga got a hit called I Just Fucked Your Girl in Some Flip Flops. Like, you be like, what the fuck, my nigga? I'm in the strip club, nigga just playing boogly oogly, oogly oogly, oogly. I'm like, what the fuck? But I figured it out. The album is a classic. The next single is produced by Illa. Actually, my son wrote the hook to that Ride So Valid. It's so fucking crazy. When y'all hear that shit, if anybody said like, damn, man, that all the way up is crazy. When y'all hear the next shit, y'all gonna really be like, yo, these niggas in they bag for real. This shit is crazy. So it ain't one and done. We rocking out, y'all. Get ready for that album.
Remember, I'm sleeping on a bill. You remember that one? You want to go there?
Yeah, I don't want to go there.
You don't?
But
That's kind of a request.
Uh-oh.
Let me play a song, another one. We only doing hits. Yo, y'all look like y'all locked up on the sixth floor or some shit. FDC, nigga, what's up? This song right here is with my favorite artist and the only artist I ever recorded with that made me nervous. Let's go.
Ooh. Yeah.
I got that shit, y'all.
Say what?
I got that shit, y'all. Yo, crack man and I'm out of the game. Niggas had they run, now it's time for change. When we step in the club, nigga tuck your chain. Got the mink on, same color the range. Poor looking for my nigga this song. Big pun, then we party like we just came home. Fuck a bitch if she act too grown. I don't need that shit, I got my rifle at home. Where's Clarence? Dirty Eric. Drunk over Henny and the joint keep burning. Dancing with Shorty and the friend keep flirting. I don't always crush too, but tonight seems certain. Party all night, fuck all y'all. Bottles in the air like we stuck up the bar. Terror squad, man, you know who we are. Cruise to your block and I'm drop tight. Belly is ours, come on.
We fucking rolling on dubs, off up in the club, wild like fuck. Got crystal pop, hitting you with no chase. So mommy, don't stop, going up, stop. I got four honeys in the drop, and my man Joe's got the keys to the spot.
And it's still with
all these guys with the tops.
We take up for your girl.
Now let me play you the record that got all of us rich. And we only played it one time on a radio station. One spin. One spin. The one time they played this next record, by the time I went downstairs, the whole industry was trying to make me a millionaire. Raul, you was with me. Let's go. One spin.
Don't wanna be a player, playing no part.
I'm not a player, I just crush a lot.
I wanna show, stick out what you're looking for.
Don't wanna
be a player, I don't wanna be a player. I'm
not a player, I just crush a lot.
Hey! Still down below.
Body cry. Body cry.
Body cry.
Body cry. More than I. Body cry, money. Rest in peace, Big Pun.
Y'all make some noise. Y'all make some noise for the Star 99 Jamz Uncensored Fat Joe. Joe. Be on the lookout of the album on the way. And be on the lookout for that next single, too. After Party at Club Euro. Shout to 1-800 The Boss, too.
Hold up.
Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. All the way up. All the way up.
Hold up. Thank you so much. God bless you. Get home safe.
Thank y'all for coming out to Uncensored. It's another 99 Jamz exclusive event. And tomorrow
we got a big announcement. Matter of fact,
on the afternoon hustle, Felicia Monet's gonna announce it.
Yes.
So tomorrow at 4:00, Felicia Monet is gonna announce the next 99 Jamz
Live.
Exclusive event, by the way. And don't forget, this Saturday, this weekend, y'all can join us on the beach side, too. Ocean Drive and 7th Ave, right in front of the Johnny Rockets. We having a 99 Jamz Peach Party starting tomorrow at 2:00. After Party at Club Euro. Shout to our sponsors, 1-800 The Boss. Where DJ Hercules at? You ready to turn up, sis?